even and odd comments. Everybody take down these problems, start copying down. So these are the problems that we are seeing. So problems, so the problems on even and odd components, odd components of a signal. Okay, so you'll be given the signal and you have to find even and odd component of such signal. Fine. The first signal that they have given us is an exponential signal. See, so x of t is a continuous time signal, okay, and e power jt is the signal that they have given us. Complex exponential signal. Okay, and since they are asking us the even and odd components of this signal is neither odd and nor even, or nor even is what we need to understand. Okay, neither odd nor even signal. So how to find out the even component of this? Okay, so we have derived the expressions in the last class. So what you have to do is you have to write those expressions. X even of t. So what is x even of t? See, in the last class we've done that. It's half of the original signal plus half of the reflected signal, time reflected. We can call this as reflected signal, okay, or time negated signal. Fine. So that's given as half x of t plus x of minus t. That means that half is associated with both these signals. Understand? So given x of t is this. Given x of t is this. Okay. So what is x of minus t? Wherever t is there, substitute that t by minus t. Everybody understand that? So how does it look like? It's equal to half x of t is e power jt plus x of minus t is e power minus jt, because t has to be replaced by minus t. Is everybody okay with this? Fine. So this looks like what? Can you tell me which form it is in? It is in complex exponential form, but it is equal to something. It's a standard equation. You can
cos hyperbolic t.
It's hyperbolic or without hyperbolic? See that properly. It's this, and this is actually cos t, not hyperbolic t. Okay, so therefore we can write, since you can say, since cos t is e power jt plus e power minus jt by 2 implies x even of t is actually cos t. Understand that? So we have found the even component of that signal. Fine. So can you now give me the odd component? Everybody go on, do it yourself. Anyways, I'm doing it, but I want you also to do it yourselves. Okay, everybody. Anyways, the expression for odd component is there, which we have derived in the last class. Okay, so using that expression, you have to find the odd component. So what is the difference in even component, odd component? See, only this sign is the difference. So here it is plus of the two signals. Here it is minus x of t minus x of minus t. Okay, so let's take that. Also, x odd of t needs to be found out. That is given by half times x of t minus x of minus t. Fine. Now this is half x of t is e power jt minus e power minus jt is x of minus t. Is this okay? Now what we need to do? So what is that? We know that. What is sine t? Anybody, what is sine t? Can anybody tell me what is sine t? Remember, it's e power jt minus e power minus jt divided by, in the numerator, what in the denominator, what is there? Can you tell me? Anybody, if you remember? Anybody? Okay. Sin t is e power jt minus e power minus jt divided by 2j. Okay. So this is the formula. See, yeah? For cos t, it is e power jt plus e power minus jt by 2. For sin t, it is e power jt minus e power minus jt, but in the denominator, instead of just 2, we'll have 2j. Understand that? So, which means that this is what? Can you tell me now? Therefore, what is x odd of t? Anybody? So, comparing this and this, can you express this in terms of the sine signal? It is j sine t. Understand that? So, this is the even component and odd component of this exponential, which is given as e power jt. So e power jt is what? Therefore we can say, since, so this is just for your note, okay, since x of t is given by x even of t plus x odd of t, okay, implies e power jt, which is x of t, can be given as even component, that is cos t, plus the odd component, that is j sine t. Okay, so this is something that you have seen earlier. So this is something that you know in your trigonometry, you know how to express your complex exponential in terms of sinusoidals, or how to express sine theta and cos theta in terms of exponentials. Okay, this is what is the result that we get. Fine. So let's take another signal and separate the even and odd components in that. Fine. Now everybody, take the second signal that is given by x of t equal to cos t, everybody just copy it down, plus sine t cos t. Okay, so this is the signal that they have given. Okay, so we have to find out the even and odd component for that, for this. So it's the problems on even and odd component. So what we are asked to find out, find the problem statement is, find the even and odd components, even and odd components of the following signals. Find the even and odd components of the following signals. So this is the first one, and we have to take the second one, and that is this. Can you give me that? Everybody just work out and give me the even component. What is x even of t given by? It is given by half times x of t plus x of minus t. Okay, now can you just go on? This is very simple trigonometry problem. Fine. So half x of t, the given problem, the given signal can be written as it is, that is cos t plus sine t plus sine t cos t. So this is given signal as it is, plus x of minus t. That means now you need to attach minus to that t. Okay, so it becomes cos minus t plus sine minus t plus cos minus t sine minus t. This is how it looks like. Okay, now what is sine minus theta? Is it sine theta? Anybody?
Sine theta.
Sine minus theta is sine theta, or minus sine theta?
minus sine theta.
Minus sine theta.
Cos minus theta is cos theta. Okay. Since sine minus theta is equal to minus sine theta, and cos minus theta is cos theta, the even component can be written as implies x even of t can be written as half times cos t plus sine t plus sine t cos t. The first signal will not change, but here cos minus theta needs to be written as cos theta, that is cos t. Sine minus t needs to be written as minus sine t. Okay, then it is minus cos t sine t. This is how it becomes. So sine t plus sine t minus sine t goes off. Plus sine t cos t minus sine t cos t goes off. So you'll be left with what? 2 cos theta within the bracket. Or 2 cos t. Fine. So there is a half in the denominator. Okay, so those two go off and you'll be left with even component, which is equal to, what? Cos t. So this is your even component. Okay, so I'll just give you the odd component. Okay, everybody should get that. Okay. Now, what is that odd component? Just I'll give you that. Take it down. Similarly, x odd of t can be obtained as what? Sine t in the bracket 1 plus cos t. This is what is going to be your odd component. Fine. Just copy it down. While asked in the exam, you'll do it. Fine. Now, you have this just for your reference. The third problem is I'll just give you the answers for this. You can obtain it yourself. The third problem, everybody just copy it down. I'm not solving it, but I'll give you the answer. You can do it as an exercise. Okay. 1 plus t cube into cos cube 10t. So this is the signal, okay? And I'll give you the answers. Get these answers yourselves, fine? So x even of t is cos cube t, or cos cube 10 t rather, okay? And x odd t is cos cube, sorry, t cube cos cube 10 t. So this is your odd component. So you can get this even and odd component yourself. So I'm just giving you the answers. I'm not sure the third signal for even and odd components. Just do it yourself. Fine. Now let's go with the fourth problem under this, a different type of problem. Fine. What is that? Now everybody just take down this problem statement. Show that, copy down everybody. Show that product of two even signals. Product of two even signals or two odd signals is an even signal while product of an even and an odd signal odd signal is an odd signal is an odd signal. So I'll just explain this. Have you taken it down? Show that the product of two even signals or two odd signals is an even signal, while product of an even signal and an odd signal is an odd signal. That means this is what they're saying. Suppose you have product of two signals, fine. And in that product, if the two even signals, let's say XE1, product of XE1 and XT2, there are two even signals. So if you take the product of this, the resulting signal would be what? Anybody, according to the statement, it's even signal. The product of two even signal is an even signal. Similarly, product of two odd signals, let's say XO1 into XO2. So this is product of two odd signals. So this is also an even signal. Understand that. And what is the third thing telling? While the product of even signal and an odd signal is what is an odd signal. So these are all products, mind you. So in the product, if both the signals are even signals, then the product is even. If both the signals are odd signals, then also the product is even. If one of the signals is even and the other signal is odd, okay, then the product would give you an odd signal. Understand? So this we need to prove. Understand that. So this we need to prove. So let's see the proof. I hope everybody understood the problem statement. This is quite a simple proof. Okay, so let's see that now. Everybody, proof. So let y of t be the product of two signals y1 of t and y2 of t. So we have taken y of t, which is going to be product of two signals, y1 of t and y2 of t. Therefore, how we can write it mathematically? Y of t can be written as y1 of t into y2 of t. So this is the assumption that we have done. Now, let's go with case one. What is this case one? Okay. And another condition that we shall put is if y1 of t and y2 of t are even signals. Okay. Then what happens is what we need to see. Call this as equation number one. Okay. Substitute t equal to minus t in one. So one implies what? One would imply y of minus t would be equal to y1 of minus t into y2 of minus t. Okay. Now we know that for even signals, we know that x even of minus t is what? Anybody? What is x even of minus t?
Okay.
It is x e of t. Good. So therefore y of minus t can be written as y1 of t into y2 of t, because they are even signals, which further implies that y of minus t would be what? What is y1 of t into y2 of t? See our equation number one. What is that? It is y1 of t into y2 of t is y of t. So that means y of minus t is happening to be what? Y of t. So what does it imply? What does it imply? Therefore, product of two even signals is what? Is an even signal. Let's go with case two. What is case two? What has to be case two? Let's go with case two, wherein, let's say, if y1 of t and y2 of t are what? Are odd signals. Are odd signals. So can you do the same, everybody yourselves? Just follow this and see what happens. So let's call this as equation number two. But consider equation two. Consider two, which implies y of minus t is equal to what? Y1 of minus t into y2 of minus t. And since y1 of t and y2 of t are odd signals, okay, what would these be? Okay, we know that x odd of minus t is actually minus x odd of t. Okay, so since these two are odd signals, we can say this implies that y of minus t is what? Minus y1 of t into minus y2 of t. Fine. So since there are two negatives, the product of two negatives would be positive. So this further implies that y of minus t would still be what? Y1 of t into y2 of t, which is y of t again. So that means in this case also, y of minus t is happening to be y of t. Okay. Therefore, what conclusion we arrive at? Okay. So therefore, we can say that therefore, product of two odd signals is also an even signal. Why did I say also? Because product of two even signals is anyways even, but product of two odd signals is also an even signal. So this is case number two. What is case number three, anybody? What is case number three? What is the problem statement given? Read that and see what is going to be your case three, everybody. And see if you can do it yourself, case three. If y1 of t is odd, and y2 of t is even. Okay, so consider equation two, which is y of minus t is equal to y1 of minus t into y2 of minus t. Since y1 of minus t is an odd signal, y1 of t is an odd signal, okay? So this is an odd signal. How does it look like? this is odd. So since this is odd, it is minus y1 of t. And this is an even signal. So what is even signal? If it is y2 is even signal, y2 of minus 2 would be y2 of, sorry, let me write this. Yeah, it's y2 of t. Okay, so how does it look like? So therefore y of minus t would look like minus y1 of t into y2 of t, which is as good as minus y of t. That means y of minus t, that y of minus t is happening to be minus y of t. So what is the conclusion here? If any one signal in the product is odd and the other signal is even, then we can say the product is odd. Okay, so therefore if one signal is odd and the other is even, and the other is even, okay, then the product is what? Then the product is odd. So this is one proof which can be asked in the exam. Okay, now let's go with some sketch. Till now we have seen how to obtain the even and odd components in the form of expressions. Okay, and we also have proved what would be the product of two even signals, two odd signals, and if the product is of one even and one odd, what happens, we have seen. Now we shall see how to sketch the even and odd components of a signal given. Fine. So let's take down the problem statement, everybody. Determine and sketch. Determine and sketch the odd and even parts of the signals shown below. Okay, let's continue with the numbers. The previous problem is third. Okay. Yeah, this is fourth rather. Let's go with the number five. Okay, so here number five onwards, it is sketch of this thing. Okay, determine and sketch the odd and even parts of the signal show. So let's go with that fifth one. So what is that given as? Now everybody just copy it down. So you have to be a little disciplined when you are writing it. Okay. So let this sketch be neat. Fine. So the signal given is this. Okay, this is the signal given. Fine. It's zero. At one, it is going maximum. At two, again, it becomes zero. Okay, the maximum amplitude that it is attaining is 1 volt, and given signal is called x of t, and this is t. So what type of signal it is? Can you give the adjectives to this? What type of signals are these? What is x of t? Is it a continuous time signal or a discrete time signal?
Continuous.
It is continuous time signal. Whether it is odd signal or even signal.
Even signal.
Neither even nor odd.
Neither even nor odd. So how to understand this is neither even nor odd? If it is even signal or odd signal, okay, it would be on both the sides of x time axis. This is time axis, right? X axis is time axis. You will have the signal on both the sides of time axis, and the duration for which it is on the positive time of side, positive side of the time axis, the same duration it would be on the negative side of the time axis, if it is odd or even. Okay, but that is not happening here. So which clearly says this is neither even nor odd, but this would contain the even and odd components which we are asked to separate. Understand that? So since we are asked to sketch the even and odd parts, okay, so we have to again consider the equation. So which equation we have to consider? X even of t. What is that? It's half x of t plus half x of minus t. So I'm considering the equation in a different form. Earlier I used to consider it as half x of t plus x of minus t. I used to take half out and I used to do that. But here what I'm doing, this half is being taken inside and it is being associated with each of the signals. Understand? Similarly, we shall consider x odd of t as half x of t minus half x of minus t. So this is how we shall consider the even and odd components. Now we need to sketch this. Okay, so for sketching, again we need to consider x of t. Again we need to consider x of t here, and then consider half x of t, then consider half x of minus t, and do it. Fine. Yeah. Let's consider x of t. Now, everybody just plot this. Let's go with plot of this. We are considering x of t. You need to have this equations with you. Fine. X even of t and x of t. And in both the equations, you need to just have half of x of t and half of x minus t. Okay. For odd signals, you need to get the difference. And the for even signal, you need to get the sum. Fine. So let's consider x of t as this. Everybody just take down this. And you need to be neat when you are doing this. You can practice this with a pen only. You never have to do this by using the pen and scale and pencil. You can do without that. You can just practice it and it will come. It will come, not a problem. You don't have to bother much about having pencil and pen. Sorry, pencil and scale. Okay. Now 0, 1, 2. And this is 1. So this is your x of t. Fine. And this is t. For even and odd components, I need to have half of this signal. Okay. So before having half of, yeah, let's do that. What is that? This signal needs to be plotted. Here, what do I need now? I need half of x of t. Fine. So how does it look like, everybody? So here is 1, here is 2. Fine. So here it is 1, the amplitude is 1. Since we have to take half of that, let's take this amplitude. Okay. So this is how it is going to look like. Fine. Now this is the x axis will not change, or the time axis will not change. What has changed? Only the y axis has changed. And what is this now? Earlier it was 1, Now, what would be the maximum amplitude of this? It would be half, or let's say 0.5. The one has become 0.5 now. So we need half x of t, and along with half x of t, I need half of x of minus t. See here, everybody, in this equation, what do I need? I need half of x of minus, half of x of t I have obtained. We need half of x of minus t. Okay, so how to obtain that? Everybody see here, we have not done this before. Let's do it now. Everybody, yeah, we have done this when we were, we have done this once. What do I need now is this. Half times x of minus t. So given half of x of t, how do you obtain half of x of minus t? Can you just write it yourselves, everybody? Those who know how to do it. So this is zero. This is one. This is two. Okay. What is at zero will be at zero. What is at one? See, yeah, what is at one would now come at minus one. So that means that 0.5 would come at minus one. And what is that two would come at minus two. So at minus two, you will have zero again. And this is how it looks like. Yeah, this is how it is going to look like. And on the other side, it comes. So it is 0.5 on the other side. Is it okay with everybody? So this is how we have half x of t and half x of minus t. Is that okay with you? Now, let's get the even component and odd component. So can you tell me what I have to do on these two signals? What I have to do on these two signals to have even component? Anybody? Okay, let's just extend these lines down. Okay. Fine. Now, you have this one here, two here, minus one, and minus two. So what we're doing, what is even component? X even of t is half x of t plus half x of minus t. So therefore, what is even component looking like? So it's, see here, you have to add these two signals. So these two signals, you need to add half x of t plus half x of, if you add these two signals, you'll get even signal. Understand that? So what would it look like? So on the other side, see here, on this side of the time, on the positive time of, you have signal here, and here you have no signal. No signal means it is zero. So any signal plus zero would get the, would give you the same signal. This signal plus zero would give you the same signal. So on the right hand side of time axis, you have the same signal coming. Okay. And on the left hand side, you have zero here and you have a signal here. So zero plus any signal would be the same signal. So on the other side, you will have this. So what is the difference? This is 0.5, 0, minus 1, minus 2, 0, 1, 2. Okay, so this is what your even signal looks like. Understand this? Now, can you go with sketching the odd signal, everybody? Do it yourselves, everybody. Sketching the odd signal. How to sketch the odd signal? How to sketch the odd signal? Let's do it. Yeah. Now for odd signal, what you need to do? What is odd signal given by? Odd signal is given by x odd of t equal to half x of t minus half x of minus t. So that means what you would do? See what you do on this minus this signal. So that means 0 minus this signal would be minus of this signal. 0 is there on the left hand side here. Okay. 0 minus this signal would be minus of this. What is minus of this signal? You have 0.5 at minus 1. So you'll have minus 0.5 at minus 1. So that is minus of this signal. And it is this signal minus 0. Any signal minus 0 would be the same signal. But 0 minus the signal would be minus the signal. So that's why your odd component would rather look like this. Okay. See here. So this is a signal minus 0 would give you the same signal. Okay. Here it is 0 minus this signal. See here. Do you see the signal? 0 you have on the other side minus this signal. So that means it would be minus of this. Minus of this means, so at 0 you have 0. Okay. At 1 you have to have minus 0.5. At minus 2 anyways you have 0. So if you join these points, it is going to look like this. So what we have obtained now is x odd of. Is it okay with you, everybody? So this is 0.5 okay, and this is minus 0.5, 0 minus 1 minus 1. So this is how odd component and even components can be drawn.